Okay, so I'm gonna be doing this video an accent tag. Now I come from Dallas, Texas. It's sort of the northern part of, well, not the northernmost part of the state, but it's in the North Texas area, which is sort of middle between kind of east and west Texas almost. There's the western part, which is that big panhandle, and then you come down, go to the east past Wichita Falls, and then you get Fort Worth and Denton and Dallas, Frisco, that whole area. That's where I'm from. I'm from Dallas, North Dallas specifically. So, what is it called when you throw toilet paper on a house? We would call it rolling or TPing. I mean, we've called it both. We've done it. It was kind of fun. Don't do it anymore. But yeah, we would. I mean, you call it TPing, rolling. I've heard both. I'm not sure which one specific region specific to where I'm from. We just heard both. There's a lot of people from all over in Dallas. So I'd imagine that'd be one reason why we hear both. What's the bug that when you touch it, it curls into a ball? Definitely roly-poly. I don't know what people say other places, but yeah, we call them roly polies. What is the bubbly? What's a bubbly carbonated drink called? I call that a soda. Now, I've heard a number of people in Texas just call it a Coke. I don't really get why, but I've heard that's a thing. My fellow Texans do say, so I just call it a soda. And I ask if I could get a Sprite or something. But yeah, I call it a soda. And of course, me going to school up here in Minnesota, I hear them say pop all the damn time. And I'm like, you mean a soda? I don't say you mean a soda. I just know that's how they say it, but I mean it's kind of funny whenever they say, "Oh yeah, you want a pop?" But yeah, what do you call gym shoes? I tip either I've sneakers or tennis shoes. That's kind of what I call them. All right, and then what do you say to address a group of people? I don't typically go with the howdy y'all. I'm not that kind of a stereotypical Texan. I typically say, hey, what are you guys doing? I'll use you guys. So I am not a stereotypical Texan that's just like, hey y'all, how's it going? No, I am. And my parents aren't even from Texas. I'm a first generation Texan. But yeah. What do you call the spider or a spider-like creature that has an oval-shaped body and extremely long legs? That'll be Daddy Long Legs. That's what I remember. Think we call them. What do you call your grandparents? Well, I've got different names for my grandparents. On my dad's side, my grandpa is dead. But I have a step grandpa. We just call him by his name. We call him Rodney. He's from, as they would say, across the pond. He's a Brit. Yeah, he talks talk he talks like this, He's from Britain. All right. And then my grandma, I just call her grandma. It's his wife. And then on my mom's side, I call my grandpa my mom's side Pops, and my then grandma Nani. So yeah, cause yeah, I don't know if that's more of a, I'd imagine they're probably more of a northern thing, cause my family's pretty much from up north. We kind of all migrated south, well, not all of us. There's still, I've got a whole bunch of family that still lives up here in the north, and then kind of my more immediate family lives down in the south, and then of course extended family. I've got extended family that lives in the south, but generally, and a whole ton of, I'm pretty sure, far more extended family in the north, because that's really where my family, you know, pretty much started when they came over here from Sweden. And then, of course, and then I'm not too sure. I know that's the only roots of my ancestors that I'm sure on. Other branches from my family, where they came from, I'm not sure. I know my mom's grandparents were, I know they came from Canada, but I think I saw they were like Irish Canadian, so that's one thing. But yeah, got a whole bunch of different shit going on there. What do you call the wheeled contraption in which you carry groceries at the supermarket? Yeah, that's, oh gosh, now I'm blanking on it. It's a shopping cart. Yeah, shopping cart. That's, it's, you know, it's not like, now I know in like Britain or some shit they call it a trolley, and you know what they might call it, some of the similar stuff like on the East Coast, probably up in New England, where they go, well, you know, they'll park your car in a Boston yard, I'll park my car in a Harvard yard, because I'm a Mainer. And that's what we do up here in Maine. We'll go down to Bowdoin. Yeah. All over them in the New England area. What do you call it when rain falls while the sun is shining? Shit, I have no clue. I don't really, I don't think, I don't know the word for that. I mean, I honestly don't know. I would just typically refer to it, that's weird. It's raining, but the sun's shining. I don't know if there's a specific word for that, so I guess I'll just move on. What is the thing you change the TV channel with? Remote control. Or I've also heard a clicker. But yeah. Accent tag words. These are the words I have to pronounce. Okay. Ant, roof, root, or route. I mean, in Dal, we say them both different ways, like depending on which word. The route would be like more of a road. But then the route, what route are you going to take? Oh, I'm going on Route 66. The route I'm taking goes along Route 66. So we use different pronunciation generally depending on the type of word, depending on how you use that word. So, route or route depends. But we don't say what's, I found a weird pronunciation up here is people say rut. Like, how do you get rut from that sort of word? So yeah, that I found funny. Oh, wash, oil, theater, iron, salmon, caramel, fire, water, sure, data, ruin, crayon, New Orleans, pecan or pecan, gosh, both, again, probably, spit and image, Alabama, lawyer, coupon, mayonnaise, syrup, pajamas, cot, naturally, aluminum, and envelope. Accent challenge videos. Enough explaining. The following videos. When taking the tag is best to signify. Okay. Yeah. So I guess it would be good for me to say. So yeah, I think I said it in the beginning. I am from Dallas, Texas, so I kind of have a bit more of a Texas accent, but my parents, not so much. My mom is from St. Louis, Missouri, lived a decent portion of her life in Chicago. My dad is from Omaha, pretty much born and raised there. And then they moved down here to Texas. So, well, not down here to Texas, because I'm in Minnesota right now. But generally, they moved down to Texas, and then I came up here to Minnesota for a school, and I'm actually going back down to Texas in a few days. I think Wednesday. The 18th. I'm gonna be going back down to Texas, so hopefully things will be all right. All right, hold on. Okay. Yeah, at this point, I'm just messing around with this. But yeah, more words I guess I could say are food, fun, how do you do? I am, my name is Perry. Jag vill prata svenska för jag vet inte vad jag ska göra nu. Men lyssna här. Men lyssna här and du kan försöka att förstå mig. För jag ska göra det roligt att lyssna till den här. So, listen to that. Oduska. Oduska 2D the hair era utrulit. Tack skulle vi ha. Hej då. And for those Americans watching, that means goodbye. And that's, I guess, my over-exaggerated Texas accent, or Southern accent, whatever you want to do. That's not the typical accent I've got, but yeah. So, bye.